I'm going to show you how to use Adobe's Generative Fill to extend a video so we can change a horizontal video to a vertical or a square or whatever we want. So for the last couple of days, some of my Adobe friends have been posting this. First of all, my longtime friend Hal Pinsky shared it on Twitter, and I was like, oh, that's kind of like what we do with cinemagraphs. And then another friend, Rufus, started sharing a really cool one with some owls and different things like that. And then Russell Brown was asking for a tutorial. So I was like, why not? Let's make a tutorial. So right now, Generative Fill is only inside the Photoshop beta at the time of this recording. Check out my other video on Generative Fill to see how to get the beta. Now we're going to choose File, Open. And what we're going to do now is we're just going to open a video directly inside of Photoshop. So I'm going to choose this 10-second MP4 that I shot. Shot this with a drone. And you'll see when it opens, the timeline will appear. You can grab the playhead here and you can scrub through and view the motion. Or you can hit the space bar and we can see. Now, if you look at this image, notice that pretty much all the motion, with the exception of that car, is happening above this area here. So what we want to do is replace the bottom area with something that is a still image. And this is going to give us a cinemagraph kind of a feel. So first thing we need to do is change the size of the canvas. We want to make it square. So we're going to grab the crop tool. Now you could make this tall, you can make it square, you can make it whatever shape you want. I'm just going to click in the middle here and drag down, and I'm going to make this square. Now if you want to make it perfectly square, go under ratio and just hit 1 by 1, and this will give us a perfect square, making sure that we're not cropping the top. Let's just get that down there, beautiful, and then just hit the enter key to apply. To view everything, hit Control or Command 0, and that will show us the entire image. Great. Now what we want to do now is we want to extend the bottom part of this image. So let's just go ahead and we're going to grab the rectangular tool, have a little bit of overlap there, maybe a little more overlap, and we're going to select that area. The beautiful thing about the Generative Fill is it's actually going to be able to extend a video. I don't even have to turn this into a still image. And it will create a new layer when I hit generate. So we're going to hit Generative Fill. And I'm going to put in bird's eye view of a modern metropolis. And we're going to hit generate. So you'll notice because we're in the video group that one of the layers happens after the other. To separate it, just drag it out of the group. See that line appears? Now it's on its own layer. And we can drag it and now we can see it. Let's go from the very beginning and extend it so that the still part of the image is the same length as the video. Now we get three variations. You can see the variations up here in the variations, or we can just hit the little arrows here and view the different variations of this particular image. And now we can see the movements happening in the top part of the image. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. Now, if you didn't want to have a metropolis, I'm gonna click on here. And let's change this from a bird's eye view of a modern metropolis to a bird's eye view of a lake. Then hit generate. There's an interesting variation there. And of course, this will just play like before. Or maybe something a little bit more industrial. Just remember, once you've created it, what you want to do is make sure to drag everything out to the same length of the video. Spacebar. And away we go. Now to save this out as a video, you're going to choose File, Export. You're going to choose Render Video. For format, you want to use H.264. And then preset, there's all kinds of presets we can grab in here. High, medium, or low quality will give us the same size as before. And just hit Render. And it will create the video. So this is just kind of scratching the surface of what we can do with Generative Fill and video. I'm going to play around a little bit more, but let me know your comments underneath. What do you guys think about doing this kind of stuff? And if you want to learn more about Generative Fill and how to get the beta, check out my video here. If you're new, hit the subscribe button, turn on notification. You won't miss any of my other videos, which are upcoming. Thanks for watching. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.